So let's now look at the frequency response. Of our bilinear transformed low-pass filter. So let's write this here, this lengthy formula again down here. So remember, that's an analog filter just now. So we have actually so a time, so a sampling interval t. And so then we have here. It's again the omega c t divided by omega c t plus 2, and then that's here z2 minus 1. So except of having quite nasty coefficients here, that's essentially still something we can put in a second order IIR filter. So omega c plus 2. And so we see here, if we think of our filter coefficients here, so that's here again, that's here our filter coefficient a1. So the IIR coefficient here. And then here we've got our B0 FIR coefficient, and then this one is here our B1 FIR coefficient. So nothing dramatic. And so therefore, in order to get the frequency response here, as usual, we're doing the E2 H2 E2 J omega, and then just then we plot this, and so the omega is running usually from 0 to 2 pi, and so here we use the scipy command frequency z, and that's the one which is calculating us this here already, and so just making life a bit easier. So we're just putting these coefficients in there, and then the frequency z command gives us the response back. So now let's create our filter here. So that's very easy. So let's first define a sampling rate. Let's say just 5 kHz, and we would like to have a cutoff frequency omega c of 2 numpy pi and 1000, so 1000 hertz, and then our t is of course 1/fs, and so now we can just populate these coefficients here, and so as I said, we use the frequency z command, and this just would like to have the coefficients nicely lined up. So let's start with the denominator. The denominator, and let's make a bit of space here. Let's see this so that we see that and move this here a bit up. Okay, so that's our function here. So that's our denominator here. So a, and so we're starting with the 1, and then the z2 minus 1 is just here t multiplied by omega c, and then do we have here minus 2, and then divided this by t multiplied by omega c plus 2. So and then with that, so we have the a coefficient, so the denominator, and then we just need to create the same for the numerator is just now a bit covered here, so let's move this a bit down, and so the numerator is here. Let's see if I manage to to move this window into our capture area. So numerator is a bit more involved here. So we've got our omega c multiplied by t, and then this is divided by t multiplied by omega c plus 2. So that's the first coefficient here, and then the second coefficient here is omega c again multiplied by t, and then does this divided by omega c multiplied by t plus 2 here. These are very odd terms in what the bilinear transform provides us, and so now we just need to calculate the frequency response, and I said we're using the frequency z command. So that's a command which is provided by SciPy, and that's very convenient. It just takes the coefficient here, so that's the frequency response, and so we're just putting b, the numerator and the denominator coefficients in here, and then this gives us directly the response out of that here. Omega is normalized in radians, so therefore we just need to make sure that we normalizing this properly here. So let's see if this gives us the response. Okay, so that's our response here of that, and so we see here, so it's starting, the filter is a low pass filter, what we have predicted. So it's starting here and then it slowly decays, and the interesting thing is, or the most important thing is here, so at the Nyquist frequency of 2500 hertz, so we're getting exactly zero damping. So remember, this didn't happen before, so therefore the bilinear transform makes this happen here, that we have this response here, and that we're getting directly a zero here, and then this response. Okay, so that's already looking pretty good. And so now we need to take care of this omega c here, because that's just now still an analog frequency here. And so what we want to do is a design of a digital filter. So now we need to take care of the omega c.